1 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 10. Now I beseech you, brethren, by the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that ye all speak the same thing.
By the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. It's not saying just saying his name. It's by what he stood for. Because if I go to the store in your name, right, and I go out there and steal, what did I do to your name? I made it look bad. So if we going after the image of Christ, we're going after the name of Christ, we're going by what he did. So if he kept all the laws, statutes, and commandments, we have to make sure that we are keeping all of the laws, statutes, and commandments. That's representing his name. You know what I'm saying? That's putting a foul blot on his name. If I don't do what he said for me to do. Because I'm representing him. I'm saying I'm an Israelite, but yet I don't do what an Israelite do. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, what I'm saying sounds good, but yet I'ma smoke this weed. What I'm saying is not good, I'ma smoke this cigarette. You know what I'm saying? Oh, I ain't gonna marry my wife. We just gonna shack up forever. You know what I'm saying? That don't line up. That's not according to what the scripture's saying.
The book of Romans, chapter 3 and verse 3. For what if some did not believe?
So what if some did not believe? What if some didn't believe this truth? Should we just stop it? This is a fad. So what if some did not believe, right? Read.
Shall their unbelief make the faith of God without effect?
So their unbelief make the faith of God without effect? What you think? So what if somebody didn't believe? Man, we ain't got to keep all them laws. Man, Christ can be whatever color we want. He can be Chinese if he want. So what if some did not believe the true depiction of what Jesus Christ looked like? What if some didn't believe that we went through the curses in the book of Deuteronomy? What if some didn't believe? Shall it make the faith of God to none effect? Shall it make God be a liar? Shall it make God say that we went through this and it never did happen? Shall it make them that don't believe like it never happened? Because the Baptist church ain't going to teach you this. You understand? They ain't going to show us the true image of Jesus Christ. They ain't going to tell us that all the other nations are subject unto us. They ain't going to tell us this. They not going to tell us that we are above all nations on the earth.
For what if some did not believe?
They damn sure don't believe. Read.
Sure, their unbelief make the faith of God without effect.
Shall their unbelief make the faith of God of none effect? Because we can say that happened. And we reading the dates in 1608. Where were we? In 1608, where were we? We were in slavery. Could we just say, nah, master, I ain't believing that. My God ain't like that. No, what was going to happen to us? We were going to be hanging on a tree.
That's right, teacher.
In 1830, where were we? Slavery. And you got 1863, 1872, 1901. Yeah, it wasn't officially slavery, but we were still enslaved. That's we're still enslaved to this day. We in 2000 and something. We are 100 years off from these dates. And we still have a slave mentality. We still running to the Baptist religion. We still running to Seventh Day Adventist, Pentecostal. We still calling ourselves by this. So does that make God not true? Does that make God a liar? Does this make his faith? No. All praises of the Most High. The Most High is starting to waken your eyes, giving you a twinkling. Nah, man, wake up. I'm trying to wake up. Right. You understand? Read it again.
For what if some did not believe? Shall their unbelief make the faith of God without effect?
Let's find out.
God forbid.
Hell no. Read.
Yea, let God be true.
Let God be true.
Right. But every man a liar.
Every last one of them a lie.
That's right.
Because they teach lies.
Right.
That's why they're a lie, because they've not come straight out of the Bible. Right. You understand? They don't teach the Bible. The Baptist church does not teach the Bible. And a lot of our people, it's a stronghold to come away from these churches. I get it. But you got to admit, you got to stand on something. You know what I'm saying? Because if you portray that image, then what is it saying about you? Are you being lied to, or are you lying? You feel what I'm saying? I'm telling you, start to keep the commandments. You know about wearing a beard. Let's show you real quick. You good on that? Leviticus 19, verse 27. Let me get you to come up and teach.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 19 and verse 27. Ye shall not round the corners of your head.
So they say you should not round the corners of your head, right?
neither shalt thou maul the corners of thy beard.
Neither shall you maul the corners of your beard. It's talking about shaving into your natural beard line. You should not surround the corners of your head like Michael Jordan bald, Steve Harvey bald, Charles Barkley bald. He doesn't be round the corners of our head. That's the Egyptian custom. To be clean, slick, and clean shaven. We learned that way during that time when we was under bondage. So that when we got those slaves, it was the first thing they do to us. They shave all your hair off your head, all off your body. Make you look like Mandingo. Make you smooth face, smooth body. So they can feel all and roll all on you. You understand? And what do? You see, they call this great big burly man, what they call him? Boy. Boy. Come here, boy. This big 6'3", 6'4", 300-something pound boy. Who does not have hair on their face? Naturally. Coming out the womb. I say coming out the womb, but just naturally. Does not grow a beard. Women and children. You understand? That's why homosexuality is rampant. Cause you don't have nothing to relate to. Shit. My face smooth. I might could wear some mascara and not show up. Nah. It's a badge of manly dignity.
That's right.
You understand? That's what the beard represents. That's a part of keeping God's commandments. Right. You start wearing your beard, start wearing your hair, they're gonna look at you crazy at that church. Oh, brother.
Carter.
Brother Carter.
Yeah.
Oh, what you got going on, Brother Carter? What you doing, Brother Carter?
Right.
Hey, you know we're supposed to come in on Saturday. Who you been talking to, Brother Carter?
Hanging out.
Brother Carter. What's ties? What are ties, Brother Carter?
Ties.
Yeah, what are ties?
Ooh, got me on count.
We ain't gonna say that though.
Ties, bringing like 10%.
10% of what? Where they get that at?
Bring it up.
Rodney, 22.
Yeah.
Well, 14. What are ties? What are ties, Brother Carter? Because once you begin to say, well, Pastor, them ain't ties. Because what are the, who are the ties for?
Bring it out.
They say the church, right? They say all this and that, right? We just seen who the church is for.
Bring it
who
out.
Them churches were for. We the true church.
That's right.
The Israelites are the church. Church ain't four walls. You understand? That ain't it. The church is us. So then, let's read it. The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 14 and verse 22. Thou shalt truly tithe all the increase of thy seed, that the field bringeth forth year by year. What's the increase of your seed that the field bringeth forth year by year? The increase of your seed, right? If I go into the field and I plant a seed, what am I trying to plant?
Something to grow food,
right?
See,
talk about food.
See, I my grandpa, he grew gardens.
Uh-huh.
Like I'm talking about fields and like acres. And
yeah.
What he'll do on Sundays and stuff, he just bring it and just have on back of his truck, y'all get
right.
It for free.
Y'all got that.
Yeah.
Right? Alright. So then now, what are they saying the tide is now?
They want 10% of your check.
10% of your check. We're going to read what the tithe is. We're reading about tithing. This is tithing in the Bible. Read. Verse 23. And thou shalt eat before the Lord thy God.
Hold up.
Can you eat a check?
Can't
eat no money. Read it from 22 again. Verse 22. Thou shalt truly tithe all the increase of thy seed, that the field bringeth forth year by year.
Uh-huh.
And thou shalt eat before the Lord thy God, in the place which he shall choose to place his name there.
Where did the Most High choose to place his name at?
The book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 6 and verse 6. But I have chosen Jerusalem,
uh-huh,
that my name might be there.
I have chosen Jerusalem that my name might be there.
The Most High chose Jerusalem for his name to be, right? So go back to Deuteronomy 14. My sister, we learned about tithing, what tithing is. That's what we learned about today.
Yeah,
sister Alicia. She say she dealt with a Israelite brother that, you know what I'm saying? She dealt with him before now.
Okay. So we going on real quick about tithing, right? Because my brother knows he's an Israelite. We know that we Israelites. So we just trying to get the message clear on what tithing is, right? So next time your pastor say 10%, you go away with a couple heads of lettuce, maybe a cabbage, a couple tomatoes or something, maybe a potato or two, right? So read it again, verse 22.
Verse 22, thou shalt truly tithe all the increase of thy seed, that the field bringeth forth year by year. Uh-huh. And thou shalt eat before the Lord thy God, in the place which he shall choose to place his name there.
So we're talking about in Jerusalem. Read.
The tithe of thy corn, of thy wine, and of thine oil, and of the firstlings of thy herds.
The firstlings of your herds, toward your cattle. Right? Read.
And of thy flocks, that thou mayest learn to fear the Lord thy God always. And if the way be too long for thee, so that thou art not able to carry it, or if the place be too far for thee, which the Lord thy God shall choose.
Because if you were scattered into other parts, right, and you was far away from Jerusalem, you had to take all your tithe and carry it to Jerusalem. Well, let's say I got a whole lot. I got acres. I can't bring all that to Jerusalem in one trip. So what did he say? Changes to what? If the way be too long for thee?
If the way be too long for thee, which the Lord thy God shall choose to set his name there, will the Lord thy God have blessed thee, then thou shalt turn it into money.
So he said, turn it into money. Turn all of what you have, turn it into money, right? Let's find out what you're going to do with that money, though.
And bind up the money in thine hand, and thou shalt go into the place which the Lord thy God shall choose.
So go to get all what you have, change it into money, then go to Jerusalem. Read.
And thou shalt bestow that money for whatsoever thy soul lusteth after.
Then you should take that money and get whatever your soul lusteth after. It still ain't said give nothing up. Did not have an apartment of land. They didn't have no land. Their sole purpose was the priest's office. They didn't have no land to grow crops, to grow oil, or to grow cattle. They didn't have no land to do all these things. So somebody got to take care of them. Somebody got to take care of the Levites in order to do the priest's service. Read.
Thou shalt not forsake him, for he hath no part nor inheritance with thee.
Meaning he don't have no part of land. So how can he survive? We got to take care of the Levites.
That's right.
Are there Levite priests today offering up a sacrifice? That's the whole purpose of the Levite priest. Was to anoint the people for their sins, to atone for their sins, and offer up sacrifice for their sins. Well then, if there are no more Levite priests, who offering up sacrifice for us now? Who is that sacrifice? Jesus Christ, the black Messiah.
That's right.
We ain't sacrificing no animals no more. Jesus Christ is that sacrifice. So to say that we have to continue tithing is to say Jesus Christ died for nothing.
That's right.
Deuteronomy chapter 14 and verse 27. And the Levite that is within thy gates, thou shalt not forsake him, for he hath no part nor inheritance with thee. Uh-huh. At the end of 3 years, thou shalt bring forth all the tithe of thy increase, the same year, and thou shalt lay it up within thy gates. Uh-huh. And the Levite, because he hath no part nor inheritance with thee, and the stranger, and the fatherless, and the widow, which are within thy gates, shall come, and they shall eat and be satisfied.
To feed the people. It wasn't to put money in my pocket so I can ride around in Bugatti. and you catching the bus. That's not what tithing is for.
The book of Malachi, chapter 3 and verse 10. Start at verse 8.
This is the one they start at.
Verse 8. Will a man rob God?
Will a man rob God?
Yet ye have robbed me. But ye say, wherein have we robbed thee? In tithes and offerings. Ye are cursed with a curse. For ye have robbed me, even this whole nation.
You have robbed this whole nation because you're not giving your tithes to what it's supposed to. I was young. Read.
Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse.
What's a storehouse?
I guess they're talking about the church, so there'll be meat. Like,
You got a storehouse. It's where you store what?
Food,
right? Bring all your tithes into the storehouse. Read.
That there may be meat in mine house.
So there'll be meat in mine house. There'll be crops in my house. There'll be food in my house to feed the people, feed the Levites. Read.
Improve me now herewith, said the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of heaven.
Because in your tithing, I will open up the windows of heaven. Why? Why would the windows of heaven be opened up?
And I will open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing that there shall not be room enough to receive it.
Why would the windows of heaven be opened up to pour out a blessing? How do crops grow? Whoa. I will open up the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing. He's going to make the land, he's going to make it rain so that your crops can increase, right, so that you can have more plentiful, so that when your 10% you ain't losing nothing.
Right.
You ain't taking all of what you got to give to the Levites. That's how they was robbing the people. The Levites were robbing the people. That's why Christ came. I got to do away with that. I got to do away with that because they is telling the ill-advised sacrifice. You understand? They robbing the people. That's they not teaching us in the church. They ain't showing us this. You got the windows of heaven? Read that.
The book of Genesis, chapter 7 and verse 11. In the 600th year of Noah's life, and in the second month, the 17th day of the month, the same day were all the fountains of the great deep broken up, and the windows of heaven were opened, and the rain was upon the earth 40 days and 40 nights.
So the windows of heaven is talking about rain being poured on the earth. That's why the tithing was so important, to feed the Levites, feed those priests. But now there's no need for those priests. Christ is the high priest.
That's right.
So then, we give Christ our tithes?
Make it plain.
So what's the purpose of it? You go up there and on Sunday and tell your pastor, look, I ain't giving no tithes. He's gonna put you out.
God expects you to do what the Lord wants you to do. Like those of you who realize that the Lord wants you to give generously into his church.
Amen.
Don't ask no questions. Don't ask how come or why come the pastor have to have him a nice house? Why come a pastor got to have a nice car? Don't ask. I said don't ask. No questions. Just give the money.
That's right.
He gonna put you out. Matter of fact, before you get there, leave. Keep the commandments. You know what I'm saying? Start to keep the commandments because they're not teaching the commandments. They're not teaching the commandments of God.
What is a nation? Nation is family. Nation is community. Nation is men leading by example. Nation is women's support. Nation is children with role models. Nation is unity. Nation is you. It's nation time.
And finally, my brother,
his word.